What? Joe Biden argues against abortion while his cabinet argues in favor of Roe. Members of the Biden administration gave talks and answered questions from the media about the recent Roe leak. According to Attorney General Xavier Becerra, the Department of Justice will double down on fighting for abortion rights. At a gala for the Pro-Abortion Political Action Committee Emily's List, Vice President Kamala Harris slammed pro-lifer Republicans for tell a woman what she can do and cannot do with her own body. And while other members of Biden's cabinet were on the same page, the president made the case against abortion. But the most interesting thing of all, Becerra, Harris, and Biden are all lawyers. And they're all running with the talking point that overturning Roe would immediately ban abortion across the country. We all know that's false. Overturning Roe means states would determine what abortion access, if any, residents will have and the restrictions surrounding it. It means the federal government could no longer force conservative red states to allow abortion if it's something their residents disagree with.
Number two, what was the second one? Look.
The second one was on abortion.
As I said when I, when this hit as I was getting on the plane to go down to Alabama, this is about a lot more than abortion. I hadn't read the whole opinion at that time. But this reminds me of the debate with Robert Bork. Bork believed the only reason you had any inherent rights was because the government gave them to you. If you go back and look at the opening comments of the Bork-Biden when I was questioning him as chairman, I said, I believe I have the rights that I have, not because the government gave them to me, which you believe, but because I'm just a child of God, I exist. I delegated by joining this union here to delegate some obligation, some rights I have to the governments for social good.
But let's talk about what a world without Roe looks like. Women in almost half the country could see their access to abortion severely limited. In 13 of those states, women would lose access to abortion immediately and outright. Those Republican leaders who are trying to weaponize the use of the law against women, well, we say, how dare they? How dare they tell a woman what she can do and cannot do with her own body? How dare they? How dare they try to stop her from determining her own future? How dare they try to deny women their rights and their freedoms?
America is not a nation prone to regression, and the Department of Health and Human Services is not in the business of stripping Americans of access and protections to care. So at HHS, we will double down on our authorities to protect every American's right and access to reproductive health care, including abortion.